No, I says, I reckon not.
Well, says he, that's all right then. I don't mind one or two kings, but that's enough. This one's powerful drunk, and the duke ain't much better.
I found Jim had been trying to get him to talk French so he could hear what it was like, but he said he had been in this country so long and had so much trouble, he'd forgot it. End of chapter 20.
Adventures of Huckleberry Finn by Mark Twain. Chapter 21. Sword Exercise. Hamlet's Soliloquy. They loafed around town. A lazy town. Old Boggs dead.
It was after sunup now, but we went right on and didn't tie up. The king and the duke turned out by and by, looking pretty rusty. But after they'd jumped overboard and took a swim, it chippered them up a good deal. After breakfast, the king, he took a seat on the corner of the raft and pulled off his boots and rolled up his breeches and let his legs dangle in the water so as to be comfortable and lit his pipe and went to getting his Romeo and Juliet by heart. When he had got it pretty good, him and the duke begun to practice it together. The duke had to learn him over and over again how to say every speech. He made him sigh and put his hand on his heart, and after a while he said he'd done it pretty well. Only, he says, you mustn't bellow out Romeo that way like a bull. You must say it soft and sick and languishy, so Romeo. That is the idea, for Juliet's a dear, sweet, mere child of a girl, you know, and she doesn't bray like a jackass.
Well, next they got out a couple of long swords that the duke made out of oak laths and begun to practice the sword fight. The duke called himself Richard the Third, and the way they laid on and pranced around the raft was grand to see, but by and by the king tripped and fell overboard, and after that they took a rest and had a talk about all kinds of adventures they'd had in other times along the river. After dinner, the duke says,
"Well, Capet, we'll want to make this a first-class show, you know. So I guess we'll add a little more to it. We want a little something to answer encores with, anyway."
"What's encores, Bilgewater?"
the duke told him, and then says, "I'll answer by doing the Highland Fling or the Sailor's Hornpipe, and you... well, let me see. Oh, I've got it. You can do Hamlet's Soliloquy."
"Hamlet's which?"
"Hamlet's Soliloquy, you know. The most celebrated thing in Shakespeare. Ah, it's sublime, sublime. Always fetches the house. I haven't got it in the book. I've only got one volume. But I reckon I can piece it out from memory. I'll just walk up and down a minute and see if I can call it back from Recollection's vaults."